Township and Library Building, and I'd like to see them put it up on the public channel so people can see it. I think traffic studies have to be done, in-depth traffic studies, because as Dan said, the two of us were at that Y meeting, and we heard, I don't want to classify them as lies, untruths, let's put it that way. We're seeing what we were told would not happen.
Yeah.
Right now, okay? And so we asked them to put it in there that they would go back and do studies and fix what had to be fixed. And that's from, that came out of that meeting. As far as the fields go, if one blade of grass, and I've stated this before, if one blade of grass is going to be touched on Veterans Field, I'm a no vote for that building if the library's there. That's just how I feel. So I don't personally, as of right now, I'm a no vote for the new building if one blade of grass is touched. I don't believe it will be, okay? I'm on record saying that, and I'll stick with it, and that's what I do. I generally pick a spot and I stay there. But if it comes in and it's more feasible to move the library, the fields aren't touched, everything else, I could vote for that. But right now, as I said, with the lowest percentage of users of any ward, I don't feel it's right for my constituents at this point. But, you know, I need to see all the numbers. So
we could do that.
We never planned on voting on this building tonight, which seemed to be what everybody thought. I mean, I was shocked. I talked about it with different people at work, different people who have watched the meetings, and nobody seemed to know what was being bid on, including me. And, you know, I never once felt we were voting on the building tonight, and I tried to tell everybody that we're not. We're voting on a feasibility study to see what the numbers say so we can do the proper thing for our constituents, and that's the bottom line. So that's where I stand at this point, and hopefully we can come up with some wording that puts all that together for the alternate bids and everything, and see what the numbers are. And vote on hard numbers, not on so much per square foot.
Okay, hold on. Please allow everyone to speak, and then those who have already spoken.
Wasn't going to interrupt anything.
Okay.
I'll pass right now.
Okay. Jane, do you have anything?
I do, actually.
Shocking.
I have, I've been sitting through all of this from the very beginning, and I'd like to thank every resident that came out and voiced their opinion. Your opinions are extremely valued. You are taxpayers. I'm a taxpayer. This entire board are all taxpayers. We all want the best thing for this community. And I know that there have been many nights, and this has been going on, and there's been a lot of confusion. I think Commissioner Siegel outlined almost everything. There are a few things I would like to say, and I'd like to preface it by saying that I put a tremendous value on education. It's been a big part of my life. My father told me growing up, it's the one thing that nobody can ever take away from you. If you have a good education, you can move on and you can do things that maybe you wouldn't be able to do if you didn't have one. I grew up in a very large family in a very, very small house. And I think our dog's name was kind of indicative of the situation. Our dog's name was Chaos. And I really value the library. When I attended Villanova University, I spent a tremendous amount of time in that library, and I also spent a tremendous amount of time at Ludington Library when I was at Villanova, because I didn't have my peers asking me to go and do other things other than study. I put a great value on libraries. I feel that our library is the only one that we have. And it is crucial to this community to have a strong library, which we do. We just don't have the facility that we need. Commissioner Wexler, as all of you know, asked me to be on the library board when I became commissioner. I went over to the library and was so impressed, and have always been impressed with the library board, and Christine Ferris has done an outstanding job. I've known her for a long time. The physical state of the library to me was astounding. I truly could not believe what I was seeing. And as many of you know, I'm a realtor. I look at houses and properties all day, every day. And when I saw the basement of that library, it truly scared me. I think there's a time and a place for improvement, and this is it. Do we build a new library? We don't know yet. And we can't possibly make an educated decision until we do have all the exact information. And in order to get the exact information, I would ask the board that we take both of these resolutions and combine them and put a time limit on it and get the proper information that we really need to give to you, the taxpayers, to give to the board so we can make an educated, informed decision. I don't want to delay the progress. I think that we have to have a police station. We absolutely need a municipal building. But we've got to step back and really look at our community, and we've got to do the right thing for the future. We have to do the right thing for our children. All these little girls that came in here tonight, do you think they don't want to come back here and live in Havertown? They will. And they're off to an incredible start. Why? Because they have caring families and community, a community that adores them, obviously adores them. We've got to give them a future. And in order to do that, we have to make the right decisions. We have an excellent, excellent board of commissioners. I don't agree with Commissioner McGarrity today, but that doesn't mean I didn't agree with him yesterday on something else. That's what makes a good board. If we didn't care and didn't think about it, and if Commissioner McGarrity didn't care, he wouldn't be a good commissioner. All of us are trying to do the right thing. I would ask that we all pull together, try to get the correct information in a timely manner, rewrite what we have here in these three options, actually, and come up with something that works. I would also like to ask the solicitor to address the question of a referendum, because at the very, very beginning of this process, one of my very first emails was to the solicitor asking if we needed a referendum. I was a new commissioner, I didn't know, and she answered me, and I asked her to answer you tonight. And I also, with all due respect, have to say to you, I appreciate Fields, but we all do have biases. And we're all biased in some way. Just let me speak. We're all biased in some way. And I appreciate Fields. I really do. And I love the CREC. I work out there every day. I go to the CREC every day. But I raise three children in this community. I have one park in our ward, Merwood Park, which was always taken up by football players. I have two lovely daughters who could never skate at the stadium because there was no ice time in those days for girls, very, very little. So I've raised three children here. I appreciate all of that. I also have a strong, strong regard for the educational system and the need for a library. And to me, you can't have a first-class community without a first-class library. If you give in to more Fields and less, you know, community, a library that really serves the entire community, I think it's a real sharp decline for this community. And I implore all of you to try and step back. And I always say to my clients, please step in the other shoes. Please, if you're on the buy side, try to pretend to be the seller for a minute, because you've got to try and see both sides. I would ask the solicitor to answer the question about the referendum, and I would beg the indulgence of the Board of Commissioners to have the president of the board, library board, Christopher Blackwell, speak to us momentarily about the ability of the library to fundraise should we need to get to that place. We are now in this open forum. Everyone's wanted to discuss this for a long time. Let's do it. Let's get some things out on the table, and then let's pull something together with all the ability that we have as a board to write something that can work for all of us. That's what I would like.
Okay. Can't.
But I'm not addressed by a commissioner speaking.
Not an open forum. It's our meeting now.
Yeah. Yes.
I did want to address one thing. She said it was just the Villanova had a library back in 82? Wait a second. I went there.
We didn't go to the same school. I went to Villanova, and I'm not sure. I think, okay. Well.
Please. Go ahead.
Wait.
Solicitor?
Yeah.
Kellen, yes. You want to answer that question on the referendum?
Answer the question about the...
I can answer
can
the question.
Can it go on the ballot?
It could go on the ballot, but it is not required to. The Local Government Unit Debt Act authorizes townships, local governments such as yourself, to incur non-electoral debt. There's a threshold to how much non-electoral debt a government can incur, and Haverford Township is far below that threshold, so it is not required to go on the ballot.
Mr. President, let me address the details of that, because it does relate, and I'll limit my comments to the issue of borrowing base and non-electoral debt and all that.
Okay, why don't you give us that?
Save for later other comments. Okay. In the financing we did in 2013, one of the things that has to be done is an affidavit has to go to the Department of Community and Economic Development of the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania when you do any debt under the Local Unit Government Debt Act. The Debt Act establishes limits on borrowing, as our solicitor has indicated. Electoral debt is used for the most part by municipalities or school districts, any local government unit, to exceed the limits that the law puts on their borrowing. So they just simply go to the electorate, and if the electorate says it's okay to borrow a zillion dollars, then they're allowed to, and they're allowed to exceed the statutory limitations. That itself is limited in that you can never have more than 350% of your borrowing base. Haverford Township has a borrowing base of approximately $33 million, and that base is based upon a certain amount of revenues and a certain amount of assessed value. And state law allows us to borrow up to 2.5 times that borrowing base before you run into the restrictions involving local government unit debt. And then you would be able to do another 100% of the borrowing base with electoral debt over that. So there are townships, municipalities, cities all through Pennsylvania that have combined electoral debts and non-electoral debts that bump up against the 350 percent of the borrowing base. We are currently at about 105-110% of our borrowing base. And in that bond, in that financing that we did, we received an A2, we received rating. A AA rating from the bond rating agencies. And when the bond rating agencies rate a township such as ours, they sit down with the township manager, they sit down with the township finance director, and with all the professionals involved in the deal, and they talk about the deal, and they talk about the township, and they talk about the township's future plans. So when they were looking at $10 million of debt in 2013 to take our total debt up to about $36 million, they knew that on the table was perhaps another $20 million for borrowing for a municipal building, a combined municipal building, because they were aware, because part of the funds that were going to be used on the 2013 money was the start of the evaluation of this multi-purpose municipal building. The rating agency found our strengths to include our modest debt profile, the above average wealth indices, our sizable tax base, and our healthy reserve levels. They indicated the analysis and the within this bond issue also indicated the total amount of long-term debt per capita in this township is approximately $756 per person. That is well below the average of municipalities in our township of our size, and therefore the idea of going to electoral debt as opposed to non-electoral debt is just really not at all invoked in this circumstance, and really wouldn't be unless we went on some really crazy capital program far beyond anything that we are discussing. I will come back to some of the other issues, but I just wanted to get some of those facts out there with regard to our current debt picture.
Okay. Commissioner, hold on 1 second. Commissioner, do you have any comments?
I do. First off, I'm not going to go on the defensive because I don't feel like I did anything, even if I say library or library. So, but the thing is, there are 9 commissioners on this table that support the library, whether they support it uptown or downtown. But the thing is, they all support the library. The library came here, I think it was in April or May, and said that they were looking for support from the board because they wanted to look at some grants, but they were also grants that we had to apply to also. Nobody on the board said no. We didn't want that. Everybody said sure. Yeah, we'll support the library for that. So my point being is that when get to the point, you're saying.
Excuse me.
When hurry up.
When the properties hurry up.
I'm just saying the horn.
When the property committee came to us in December, in October, and said, "Hey, you know what? Be open-minded and can take a look at this." Absolutely, I can certainly take a look at it. We went from the 3 floors to 4 floors. The parking were issues and what have you, and the introduction was with the library. At that point, I don't think, again, anybody didn't say that they didn't support the library. But what I would like to see from the library would be, if you had that space, what would you do with it? What would it couldn't be a 5-year plan, because by the time it is built, said, and done, it would probably be, 2017 or something to that effect. But what are the plans of the future for the library in a position, in a space like that? And what would it be where they are now? What is the library's plan for the next years for the township? I would like to see alternatives. I would like to see, I have a concept plan for a police station and a township building. I have a concept plan for police station, township building, and library, without any traffic studies, et cetera, et cetera. But there is no concept plan on all these ideas of what the library could be at Mill Road.
We have a plan.
Well, I don't have the.
Get it to you. It's the Casaccia plan.
Casaccia.
So, absolutely, I would like to see the alternative plans, an updated plan. How old is the plan for?
About 2 months old.
Just recent?
Casaccia.
It's recent. Yeah.
Casaccia, yes, it's in the last.
So, like to look at the alternative plans, great, and addressing the traffic, everything. So, before I make the decision, but to let you know, absolutely, open-minded, looking at the plans, do support the library, but I would like to see more.
Okay. Commissioner Wexler.
Yes, I've served on the property committee for the last couple of years, and I'd like to thank the members, all 4 of us that were on there, Commissioner McGarrity, Commissioner Hall, and Commissioner Siegel, who, thank God we have a lawyer, he can be elegant, but, and again, the major trigger, when we looked at that, we ranked those, and I think we had pretty much unanimous consensus of the priorities that we gave a couple of years ago that Commissioner McGarrity refers to, and it was the maintenance facility, the police department, the administration building. And it wasn't until the library came with a lot of problems, mold, remediation, all the basement issues. And then when we got the concept from the architects on there, as Commissioner Siegel pointed out, we didn't come up with the site development. Mr. Boghossian was on the committee, Mr. Galman, they came back. When they pointed out at the same time when the library came back with its troubled building that they could increase the parking from 159 spaces to 356 spaces, It begged us to look at it. We felt that we had a responsibility to look at that land, to move that in order to create the problem. And Mr. Connell, there is the library spent around $45,000 for an architectural study of the current library. Mr. Casaccio was the architect that was commissioned. I've seen the first rendering. They have renderings of it. Those reports can be sent to all of us. The price tag that they put on it was about $5.5 to $6 million. To renovate the existing facility. I personally, at a property committee meeting, and I don't know if Mr. McGarrity stayed for that one or not, I felt I had a hard time voting for a building, spending $5.5 million for a building after renovation would still only have 17 parking spots and 1 handicap spot. My ward is on the other side of Westchester Pike. I'm continually faced with complaints about parking. I have senior citizens have the reading group in the morning. They're being ticketed because we have permit parking along Mill Road and the side streets to prevent school students from parking in front of homes in that area. So 17 spots with baby crews and reading groups and senior groups fill up in the morning, and then with permit parking and no other the ability. We tried to put about 8 years ago parking lots were attempted to be built to buy the house. That was fought by the neighbors and by the commissioner. So obviously, there's no middle ground there. There's no parking. There's 17 spots, and there's no impetus to take parking locally. The residents don't want street parking. They've actually fought for and gotten permit parking, so students can't park there, and they'd be fighting with the students to park there. But the condition of the library was the major trigger for us to include it in the study and the addition of the concept plan to do that. To answer the other questions, once we come up with a feasibility study, and I'd like to see this done, you know, probably by the May meeting, I'd like to see an architect come in and give us the feasibility study of what that cost could be. Then we, just like we had to do with the Quarry Center with a private developer, the township has to go through the land development process. It has to do all the traffic studies. It has to do the traffic counts. It has to look at the lights from intersection all the way back, you know, a mile back, what the engineers determine that the traffic study has to happen. This doesn't just happen with a single vote that we say yes or no. And the concept that the library is going to be on the fourth floor first, the concept was a building. The library could be on the first floor, the second floor, the third, or the fourth. Doesn't matter. The only thing that was in concrete is that the police station has to be on the lower level with private entrances on Columbus Road and Manoa Road for high-speed ingress and egress, security of prisoners, security of police personnel, and to meet with all the federal requirements for access to a police station. So, but I'd like to thank all the commissioners with no malice in any. We always agree to disagree. It's a great procedure, what we can do, but we'd be remiss if we didn't look at this property based upon what Mr. Galman and Mr. Bogosian and the architects came up with as far as the site plan and being able to increase the parking in around the stadium, reconfiguring the lot, taking over where the police station currently is, adding spots, even the future possibility if we need more to build a parkateria to make that a parking garage with multiple tiered parking as opposed to just level ground parking. So all those contingencies were looked at, and I'd like to thank all four members of the property committee, all the architects, all the planners that went with it, and they did a great job. And now it's time to turn it over to the board to do the rest of the job there. So thank you very much.
All right. Commissioner D'Amelio.
Oh. I wasn't going to say much, but...
Okay.
Great, right? Somebody said great, right?
You still won't. I'm kidding.
I'm sure I won't articulate like an attorney does, Mr. Holmes.
I'm just praying.
And I apologize for that I didn't become an attorney. But
painful.
It is painful. I'm in a unique position on this board because I'm the only one that hasn't supported a building of any kind. And I kind of agree with Commissioner Heilman, believe it or not, because I think there's a lot I think I need to learn. I need to know about. I don't think we have that yet. I was looking at something. I just looked up on the internet. I saw something on September of 2013 on NBC News, which was the Library of the Future. And that was pretty neat. And I thought maybe that's something we can do in Haverford Township. And that would be having a combination of like a digital library with like iPads and things and whatnot. And maybe for the children have some books, I guess. I don't know. I'm not a... No.
Library, dude.
What I'm trying to say is like children...
The transcript right there.
Children like to hold books. So that's why I said that. More so than maybe...
Old people like me.
More so than... Well, iPads are probably better with them. I don't know. I'm just trying to think of different concepts that I don't know if we're there with those concepts yet. Anyway, taxes are a reality as well. And Mr. McGarrity is correct that taxes just keep increasing. And I think that many residents in the past couple of months have loudly said that they wanted us to hold off on any buildings and wanted the library to stay where it is now. Having said that, I've been in there, and I did see the conditions, I hope that some of them, I understand some of the issues, like the water was addressed, the water issue, or is that still?
Well, we found a spring there underneath the building today, so.
But the problem is that is the township building, is the township building adequate?
All right, please, let the commissioner speak.
And I think it is. We all would like to have beautiful new buildings, but there is a cost to that. Some residents have expressed that, you know what, I have, my house was built in the 40s, my wiring's old, my plumbing's old. We all get water in our basements, and we get mold. I know I've had it. You don't knock down your home. But there's so much information, I think, that we need to get. And again, I agree with Commissioner Heilman. I need to see a lot of what the concepts are, the costs are, the pros and cons of moving it. I also agree that children probably would go to where the police station is. But at what age would go there? I don't know. There's so many different, it's just so wide open. But the bottom line is the cost would be $28 million. Is that right? Is that what I heard?
18. Approximately?
18
to?
No, 18 million.
Just 18?
That's up in the air, Steve.
I don't think we should put numbers.
Let's say.
Wait till it's bid.
Let's say 20 million for sick around numbers. But if we do build this, my question is, do we do this with a grant or we do this with, we borrow from the bond? Is that what we're going to do?
You do both.
We're going to bond?
Grants and bonds.
All right. So if we do a bond, wouldn't it be wise if we did do a referendum to see if the residents, because we're going to borrow, do you want your township to borrow X amount of money to do X amount of projects? Why not do that?
Well, the one problem with it that I would see right now is it would put it off for probably a couple of years because we're already into primary season. It's not on the ballot for the primary, so it won't be on the ballot for the general. So now you're looking next spring at the very earliest. And
yeah, that's not that far off.
Okay.
Let me just say, though.
Spring, and it's a good distance off.
But Jeff,
2015, we're talking. Look at the the police station, the current state of it. We've been putting it off for too long.
I agree, but Haverford State. I'm the only one left on this board from Haverford State. It took 18 years.
Watch how you say
much
that.
Too right? long.
18 years to get that.
There's
straight
a couple
now.
That should have been there.
That's when I first ran.
But I'm just saying. So there was no rush there, and there shouldn't be any rush here because you're spending a lot of money. And there's nothing wrong with what Mr. Breslin and others have said. Let the voters decide. Nothing wrong with that. Now, can I ask Mr. Gentile a couple questions, please?
Go ahead.
Okay. Larry. You and your feelings, or do you agree or disagree about fixing the current library up or moving it down to the police station?
Me personally?
Yes.
That's a challenging question. I'll tell you personally, as a resident, as the township manager, I am not in favor of putting a library adjacent to the police department. I've heard the members of the board and their opinion, but I also have a public safety background, and that's the majority of the years of experience. I also see the amount of crowds of the children that hang around the stadium at the time, and I just think that bringing additional youth to that particular site could bring some other challenges. But again, I have not seen the actual any proposed plan, so I don't know.
Why did we build a skate park there?
I'll be the first one to move that skate park, Mr. Wexler. And I was never in support of it, so I agree. And in fact, the police department wants it out of there and been asking for it to be out of there for a number of years. It's actually brought the majority of the kids that are there are not even residents of the township. And so it's in disarray, but that's my personal opinion. It's the first time anybody's asked me that. So
okay, is this a correct figure? Last year, just last year, did we fund the library $1,023,000?
Yeah, I believe it's $1,064,000.
So we have funded the library year after year after year, and each year it's gotten a little higher. This year, I think it's almost $1,090,000. Am I right?
Correct. Somewhere
okay.
In
it doesn't. Don't
so it's not that anybody on this board disagrees with funding the library, but would you agree for the library now? I have nothing against
budget.
I have nothing against Mr. Castaccio doing what he did and giving us a bid, or saying what his quote is. But don't you think we should get two or three quotes to find out what other people feel. I mean, maybe they'll be higher, maybe they'll be lower.
This is what we're
talking
about doing.
Yeah, you have to.
This is what we're proposing.
Okay.
You can't build something on one bid.
You can't.
Hang on. You can on professional services. They don't have to be bid. We could hire an architect. Right. We could hire engineers. We can do all that. They come out with the building. The building has to go out for bid. We can't award it on one bid.
No.
Correct.
You know, we have to have I think at least three bidders. And they have to all be qualified. They have to be responsible. They have to. There's a whole process laid out for it. And you know, and the architect and engineer aren't going to let people bid it who are not
qualified.
People that are people that are not qualified to do it. There are going to be people who they've worked with in the past and they know could do a job of this type.
Well, that's what you want. Is somebody you've worked with in the past?
Qualifications. Yeah. And then we would do the
which,
bid process.
Right.
Okay,
that
but
we would know who, if they were qualified.
It's just like the brochure that made a statement that, well, now there's two schools that, and I assume that's Chatham Park and Sacred Heart, that's closer, would be closer to the library. Well, I see here eight schools that would be further to the library, but that wasn't put in that brochure. Chestnutwald, Linwood, sure. Coopertown, the middle school, the high school, John Newman, St. Dennis, and Annunciation. That wasn't in that brochure. Eight would be further away, and the two would be closer.
Excuse me, what brochure is he speaking of?
I'm talking about the things that we passed out, like in something like
that. Oh,
this.
That's Gary okay? Bogosian's. That's not ours.
Yeah. No, this is Gary's on this side. This is the township plan on this side. But there's literature that was passed out.
Gary's.
And I think Dan Siegel had made that statement about the schools.
That's all Gary's
talking. Okay. Yeah, but that's Gary characterizing, I believe. If Gary's there, I mean, he could answer that. But I don't think anybody here has ever said that. I think Gary characterized.
Oh, it was said and it was written.
All right, okay. But all right. If I could just address the one issue about walking. You just have to be on Eagle Road any day between 1 o'clock and 6 o'clock and realize that nobody walks anywhere in this town. They don't walk from CVS to Mom's Bake at Home Pizza, okay? The only people who can walk to this library are people who live within walking distance of this library. We have 10 square miles in this township. 9 square miles of those 10 square miles are full of people who aren't going to walk to either library. It's just not what our community is. It's not who we are as a society anymore. We're not people who send our children out the door at 7 o'clock in the morning and say, come home tonight when you're hungry and go play around. We drive people everywhere. We have to put them in our cars with the safety seats. We have to bring them. We have to cart them around, okay? So the idea that a 3-block difference is going to make a difference in terms of how many people are going to walk to this library just isn't so. 234,000 people came to the library last year. They didn't all walk there. I would hazard a guess, and the library can tell me otherwise, that fewer than 5% of those visits was were from people who actually walked there. So,
spots.
Yeah, for 17 spots. So it is preposterous that we're, you know, that part of this is the idea of, well, what's more centrally located? Nothing in this town is centrally located except for whatever location is saying, I wish it were near me so it would be centrally located. We're big 10 square mile square, and everybody is too far from something in this township. So, I whether it's closer to two schools or farther away from eight, kids from Chestnutwald aren't walking to Mill and Darby. Kids from Chestnutwald aren't going to walk to Manoa and Darby. They're not going to walk to the Crack. They're not going to walk to the public works yard. They're not going to walk to our township building or come to this meeting. They're going to get driven somewhere. So we have to think about just how we deal things with in terms of, you know, the way modern people get around and go places.
Okay. Mario, can I just finish with Larry? Number one, on this, I believe that I'm not sure if it was a township or the library, and maybe someone can answer from out there, but the orthodontist.
No, they can't answer.
Okay. No, from the library. Okay.
No, go ahead.
All right. The orthodontist. We tried to purchase that building. Am I right, Larry?
We did look into that, yes.
And what happened? What did they say to us?
It was exceeding our cost.
It was $1 million.
I thought they basically said they didn't want to lease it. They wanted to lease it. They didn't want to sell it.
Correct.
And what they said was they wanted to lease it instead of selling it. And we said, well, we wanted to buy it. And basically, I guess it was a couple months later. You could tell me if I'm correct. A couple months later, they did sell it to the orthodontist.
So obviously, your price wasn't right. Everybody has a price.
Well, we never gave them a price.
Well, I'm guessing...
I'm sure we would have paid...
I'm guessing a decision was made somewhere because you didn't buy it.
Yeah, well, I'm sure that we would have paid the price, the cheap...
Commissioner Garrity, you have the floor. Go ahead.
Finish.
That's...
Okay, the final thing, Larry. Golf Road, isn't that a township street?
That is a township street, yes.
Okay, so if you take Gary Bogosian's plan about parking, which adds about 8 spots, and then if we took 10 spots along Golf Road and made them library parking only, or put meters in there, whatever, it's a township street, is there a problem with that?
I don't believe so. I'd have to refer to our township engineer prior to me coming here. I believe at one point there were some decisions made, and the school kids were parking in the residential streets. So it was a negotiation between the school district and the township. I believe it was Mr. English at the time, that they did create some additional parking there to allow the teachers. So yes, those majority of those spots do belong, I believe, belong to the township.
Yeah, well, I think what you're talking about, Larry, is 1992 when I became commissioner up by Walton Bunce's house. We took the road and pushed it back to the sidewalk and made about 30 spots there, and school teachers use those spots.
That's correct.
So that's what we're talking about there. And what people, and I'm sure a lot of people were not here, but back in 1974, and maybe some people should have been here, but 1974, the library had a choice of one of two things. And I'm not blaming anybody out there. You guys weren't around from the library. But in 1974, here was a choice. Either you're going to expand the library and make it look a lot better where the front entrance is now, or you're going to put parking there and leave the old library exactly where it was. Well, the board, I guess, at that time decided that we're going to make the library bigger. Well, they did make the library bigger, and they made it a lot more attractive, but they created even a bigger problem than what they had, and that was no parking.
Commissioner Hall, did you have something?
I just, you know, it's 40 years ago.
Yeah, but
I don't even know how to answer that.
Well,
I was barely here.
He
was the only one that was here.
I'm the only one that was around, but I'm only bringing up a statistic.
You have to take his word for it.
I know. I'm just saying I really think we need to kind of leave that in the past and move into the future. That's what this is about, and I implore the board to look at these three options, come up with something that allows us to move forward on the appropriate studies so that we make an educated and informed decision so that we make the right decision this time and we don't put on some weird addition that didn't, you know, move into the future as well as Mike Brady might have liked it to, but, you know, instead of doing parking. So what we need to do is we need to look at this, vote on a way to proceed, put a time limit on it so that we get it done in a timely manner so that we can make progress. We've got to move forward on something, whether it be one building, two buildings, whatever it may be, we've got to make a decision. I think we've given it a lot of time. I think all of us, and I really appreciate what every commissioner has done, particularly the property committee and all the residents, but I think it's time. And I would ask the board to take these three options, combine them in an informed and articulate way that will allow us to move forward in a timely manner and possibly by the May 5th work session have the information that we need to make a vote. Thank you.
Mr. President.
I don't think May 5th, I think that's really pushing it. I think you need time, and I mean, you need quite a bit of time.
Okay. We've had so much time.
We're asking the people to spend $20 million, so let's let them make a decision.
I just want to make one minor point.
Yeah, please do. I just don't want to talk about finance.
This board had authorized the property committee, and we had proceeded with requests for qualifications on the municipal services and police station, which we knew at that time was a proposed expense of approximately $12 to $13 million. This debate is not over $18 million. It's over whether we spend the additional incremental money. We've already authorized, if we hadn't mentioned the library at this stage, we would already have qualifications and we would probably be in the process of selecting an architect. So the public has to understand, we had already moved ahead with that. It was when last May the library became an issue that we slowed down a little to address it. But the thought that we're suddenly it's zero or 18. This board had already, as a majority, approved moving forward. We'd already funded a partial bond for the initial money. So really, the issue that we are debating here is whether the library is included in that project or not.
Okay.
And if I just want to.
Well, I think what we need to do is work on the language for a combined.
We happen to have.
Yeah, I'm in a minute. I'm going to actually tell you.
Everybody
would
be
happy
with.
I'm going to amend my resolution delete it and replace it. I'd like to address though two issues, Mr. President.
Well, okay, hold on one second.
Yeah.
But. Go ahead, Commissioner.
And it has to do with finance. I just want to make sure that there's good information out there and not a lot of the. Not a lot of the hyperbole that's been put out there. As far as electoral debt goes, people need to understand those are election questions that are put on ballots statewide to see if we're going to spend $175 million on this memorial or some other thing. The debate that would go on at this level for us to try to even agree to what language should go on the ballot would take us a year. Then once that language goes on the ballot, it's out of our hands as commissioners as to what we could spend or whether we can do it. For the people who don't want to spend the money, if you're outvoted by as few as one person in the township, we're committed to spending the millions that we put on the ballot. If one more person, you know, than not says they don't want to do it, we can't do it at all. What you're seeing instead is what commissioners ought to do, which is have a serious debate, take in public input, talk about this stuff. You're a lot more likely to have a compromise at the end of the day that maybe satisfies no one perfectly, but actually takes care of what we need as a township. And we have a lot more control over it. And frankly, it's our duty to exercise that control over something like this. Spending money on a library is not something that I need to go to the electorate and ask them whether or not I have permission. I've
that's
three times I've gone to the
saying.
Electorate. Please let me finish.
No, because
Miller.
You interrupted
then, please
me.
Please let
that's
me
not
finish.
What I said.
Steve, I'll
only
give you
interrupted
time
you to
talk.
Make fun of you. I didn't stop
that's,
you.
That's
well,
that's not what I yeah. said, Mr. Attorney.
I didn't say you said anything.
Well,
I'm
you're
saying
characterizing it that
we
I said
don't
it in that
need
fashion.
To go,
and I didn't.
I didn't say anything about you, Commissioner D'Amelio. I'm talking
for
about
the
question.
For the record, it was spending the entire money.
I'm talking about the question that was asked as to whether or not we need to go to the public and ask them to vote on whether or not we should spend money on a library. That is my duty as a commissioner, is to evaluate that. I've been to the electorate three times, and three times the people of the 6th Ward, rightly or wrongly, have put me into this position, knowing my position for all of those elections is we need to spend money on badly needed capital projects in this town. And you count on me to exercise my discretion, and you count on Mr. McGarrity to be a counter to that. You count on Mr. D'Amelio, Mr. Oliva, Mr. Heilman, Ms. Hall. You count on all of us to rein each other in and come up at the end of the day with what works best. And that's the proper way to do this, to punt it to the electorate. Is to put back into the electorate's hands the duty they delegated to all of us to do. So that's, I would never support going to the electorate on this. We go to the electorate every 2 years when half of us are up for election. People know how we do things, and we really need to then exercise the discretion people have given us. Now, this township has approximately $36 million of long-term debt out in the world right now, and that debt's being paid off over the next 3 years. Understand that that costs us about $1.6 million a year. Now, by comparison, trash collection is $3.7 million a year. Now, when I talk about long-term debt in this township, I mean every single physical asset we have in this township that has either been recently built, recently renovated, or needs to be maintained. And I mean the sewers, I mean the roads, I mean every building, I mean the stadium, I mean the fire trucks, I mean the firehouses, all the things that we've built over time. We need to do with long-term money. It's the only proper way to do it. You want people to pay for 30 years for an asset that's that works for 30 years or beyond that. So our cost every year of maintaining the amount of long-term capital debt we have is approximately $1.5 million. If we borrowed 20 more million dollars to do these projects we're talking about adding approximately $60 to the average tax bill and the median tax bill in this township, okay? People just have to know what's really at issue here. Money is very inexpensive. It is as cheap as we are ever going to get as a township. It is, these are the lowest bond rates we've ever had available to us. Yeah. We have a AA rating without insurance. As a township that desperately needs capital, it needs to spend money on badly needed capital projects, there is never a better time than now to do it, as well as the opportunity to get these things built as cheaply as possible because people want the work. So in terms of financing, the longer we wait, simply the more expensive it will get for us and the more dire the situations we're trying to fix or replace will become. And we do not want to end up in a situation like Commissioner Siegel has described, where the library just eventually tells us one day, we can't let people in here while we deal with this issue. And then it's not a function of, can we keep them long enough while we build something else? We have to just up and pick them up and send them somewhere else while we try to deal with, at that point, what will be an emergency situation. Now, it seems to me that all nine people of this board seem to be unified in the idea that more information and more detail is a good thing. I had proposed a resolution number 1925. I would like to withdraw my resolution 1925, and I would like to read into the record a substitute resolution that I would like to put in its place. I forget who seconded me. Anyone know?
It was Jane, I believe.
Hold on a second.
Wait a minute.
Hold on. I would like.
Oh. Hold on.
I can do this anytime. It's my motion, no. My resolution.
But there was a motion by Commissioner McGarrity to add a third option to 1925, which was seconded.
No. He moved 1929. Here's a whole new resolution, right, which I'm not deleting. I'm just now substituting my resolution, 1925, with a new resolution, which I will read into the record.
Can I use your
motion? He moved to add 1929 as an option to 1925 in its entirety, so that you would have your 1925 has two now therefores, now therefore one, or now therefore two.
Okay.
Commissioner McGarrity motioned to make 1929 now therefore three.
Well, no. Because 1925 has all the same whereases and then a resolved and then one optional resolution. 1925 is a completely reworded resolution, all new whereas provisions and a new resolution. So it's a different resolution. I can substitute my resolution for 1925, and it just means we will consider my substituted 1925 or Mr. McGarrity's 1929.
Right. Right.
Am I correct, Madam Solicitor?
That's correct.
Yeah, that is correct. So you will have a new 1925 for consideration. Or 1929 for consideration, and then we'll take a vote on yes.
So what I would like to I would like to substitute the language that I had said in 1925 with the following language: whereas at the May 13th, 2013 meeting of the Board of Commissioners, the Board of Commissioners approved the retention of bond counsel to explore funding opportunities in part for the construction of a municipal services building that include the township and police administration facilities. And whereas the Board of Commissioners adopted resolution number 1886-2013 declaring the official intent for the use of bond proceeds should the board proceed with the bond issue, which includes the aforementioned buildings. And whereas the property committee issued a request for qualifications for design teams for the development of plans and specifications for the proposed municipal services building on June 30th, 2013. And whereas on September 9th, 2013, the Board of Commissioners adopted ordinance number 2705-2013 authorizing the issuance of Haverford Township 2013 general obligation notes series, I forget what series it is, for up to $10 million. And whereas the Board of Commissioners has, through the Property Committee, explored the possibility of expanding the Municipal Services Building project to include the library within the proposed Municipal Services Building. And whereas the Board of Commissioners desires additional information to demonstrate whether inclusion of the library is financially and structurally feasible within the proposed Municipal Services Building. Now therefore be it resolved that the Board of Commissioners of the Township of Haverford directs the Township Manager and his staff to commission an appropriate study or report by a qualified architect, engineer, planner to address alternate design program possibilities, such as a combined police municipal library building, a combined police and municipal building with a renovated existing library, or a combined police and administration building and a new library located elsewhere, in order to examine a wider range of possibilities. This study or report shall include general program area summaries for each component, site utilization design plan sketches, approximate parking analysis and layouts, general financial costs and considerations, and general traffic issues and recommended strategies. Such study to be presented at the May 5th, 2014 Commissioner's Work Session, resolved this 10th day of March 2014.
Okay.
Can I see the copy that you have there?
Second.
Can you hand me the copy?
Well, we're gonna,
okay, this is a little cleaner copy. Yeah.
Second to his motion. Okay.
To amend the original 1920.
Now, I would like.
She has to accept the amendments, Jane. Second?
Yeah, I was seconding the amendment. She seconded withdrawing before, and now.
I seconded it the first time that Larry brought it. I seconded it.
I think means she has to second
it again
to
second
accept
it.
My changes.
Oh, does she?
To accept my changes.
I second your changes. I do. I second.
Okay.
What happens with mine?
No. Now we vote. Sorry. We vote on it. And what I would like to say, again, is this is not, this will not be a vote on the buildings tonight or May 5th.
Right.
It's just May 5th is just
good point.
It's feasibility. You won't bid, you won't vote on a building until it's actually gone out to bid and we have hard numbers from contractors. That's how it works. I mean, that's the process. You can shake your head all you want. It's the process.
Just so folks.
Not created during this meeting.